Almost forgot I did not hit the record button. Lord, I'm slipping. But yeah, so we're on our way to the zero, I guess the area zero. It's raining. Person doesn't care. I just want to get to where I need to get to. What the hell is that? That's the dog. Never mind. Let me go and catch this, because I need me one. I couldn't find that damn thing anywhere. At least I don't think I caught one yet. But no, I definitely need to get one of these, because I need a Gardevoir. I can hope is that this is a girl. That's the ones that evolve into a Gardevoir. For those that want to know, how the hell did you get so many Pokeballs? Shut up. Mind your business. Or don't tell you if it's a girl or not. I guess I did have, oh no, I didn't have one. Oh, I did have one, hold on. No, I want a goddamn Houndour. I guess the only way for me to get one is to go back to that. That's a girl. That's a boy, so that's a goddamn Gardevoir. I mean, that's a Gallade. I can't use them for what I want to use them for. This is the place. Yep, we going the right direction. And over here. To think it ends with this guy. This is Zero Gate. It was made so researchers could try to observe the inside of the crater of Paldea. What folks call Area Zero. So I tick it down into the crater. Oh, and speaking of the crater, you know that the Pokemon of yours, the one I gave you? Area Zero is apparently where Maridon was born or something like that. Maybe it'll be happy it can finally come back home. Not that I really care or anything. Anyway, our two new teammates should be waiting for us inside Area Zero. Guess we should head in. Kinda in the dark here. And there's Miss Annoying. Raven said it'd be turning to strong Pokemon, so here I am. Once she heard she'd get to battle awesome Pokemon, she was here in a second. You're an annoying little pest at the academy, but I guess you could come in handy for this. Spoken like a guy who wants to get beaten in battle. More importantly, why is it so dark and where are the awesome Pokemon? Yeah, it's weird, the lights are off. Last time I was here, the electricity was up and running, but now. Now the lights are on. Why? I turned them on. Seems like they were on power saving mode. I hacked into the system's controls and overrode the settings. Oh, it's you, the kid with the fluffy Eevee bag. I guess. My name is Penny. Hey, we never got actually talk. I'm Nimona in class 1A. You must be the some kind of tech whiz. You're like Pokemon Battle the 2. Lord have mercy. You talk like way too... Ooh! Woo! 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 Man. Say it again. Kind of breaking the fourth wall there. Man, how many times have I been saying that? Too damn much. The director introduced us. You need to someone with good tech. She's a no-brainer. Anyway, Penny here agreed to help when she heard it was to help Formula. I'm not really in the adventuring type, but I owe you and I pay my debts. He's surprisingly old-fashioned like that. And of course, everyone knows me, Arvin, my... Yeah. Biometric identification process. Hello, I've been expecting you. It seems like you've gathered a group of Formula allies. Formula. So who are you? That's my dad, probably. Professor Turo? Nimona, still not... Ain't nobody give a damn about that. Thank you for coming. Of course, Professor. Oh my gosh, it's such an honor to meet you in person. Maybe not in person exactly. Arvin, did you tell your dad about us? When would I have done that? To begin with, I'd like to ask you to make your way down to the crater. You can reach the lower chamber by using the elevator you see to your right. Dad, please proceed below. Are you not on good terms? Must not be. Is there anything around here? No, ain't nothing around here. Thought they might have like a hidden item or something, but apparently not. This game's audio is still way too low. Biometric identification process identifies confirmed. Identities confirmed. Access granted. Works automatically. Not quite. This is someone controlling the stone button. Once you step through, you will be above area zero. You brought Marauder on with you. Thank you for bringing it with you and many adventures. If you utilize Marauder's gliding capabilities, you should be able to descend into the depths. Oh, isn't there like an elevator or something? Wait, you said Marauder can fly? Reach the bottom, I will get in touch with you once again. Hope your trip isn't uneventful. Railroading people into stuff, it's like always. Can't wait to see what Pokemon live down in Area Zero. Let's go. That girl, is she like incapable of fear or something? I guess we better go too. What's the matter with it? Scared of heights? I'm gonna say, no matter. I don't need to be scared if we go together. How does that logic work? I'm back here again. I think I might have died once or twice in here. Tries to go back in its ball. It's probably just hungry or something. Wait a second, where's the student council girl? You don't think she... Anyone, you have to see this. Area Zero is amazing. I guess your ability would be your own temple, huh? Biometric identification and process for humans identified. Mission satisfactory, vital signs on well within normal range. It appears you were able to make the descent without being harmed. Yeah, sure, smooth sailing. Who could possibly complain about a landing like that? That is good. I have concerns you might fail given the crudeness of the only available access method. I think your dad's sarcasm detection needs fixing. You were worried about us? That's so sweet. You should make your way to me at the Lab Zero. At Zero Lab in the deepest part of Area Zero. However, the entrance to the lab is barred by four locks installed on the exterior, which I cannot unlock. Four locks. On your way to me, just visit four research stations that were constructed inside the crater. At the station, you'll be able to disable one of the locks. Do so as you make your way down. Hope you succeed. Sounds kind of video gamey when you say it out loud. This game is slowing down badly. Care about this damn Pokemon. They're probably high level or something, but at this point, I don't really need no damn. What the fuck is that? I don't have one of those. I've been talking in the middle of me trying to catch something now, so this is a problem. What the fuck is that over there? Are partly turned steel, they become a heavy result. This Pokemon flies to the skies and leaves. I don't have any one of these either. What the fuck this is? This is new. I've been in there. Frostmoth? I'm gonna put another ball in there. I'm gonna have to reset this. It's not acting the way it's supposed to. It causes blizzards as it flies with its huge wings. Clean melt water is its favorite thing to drink. Oh, I have Snom. Okay, it evolves into that. Okay. First things first, man. Got it. I wish it would stop fucking talking so I can save, man. I think I got the baby form, but I don't have. Peony dust. It's careful to prevent his egg from breaking, however, it's extremely fast at running away. I'm assuming Blissey is his other form. Petalil, I have one already. How the hell is he just running so effortlessly through a damn water and I'm sitting there? That's crazy. I gotta reopen it. Cause I don't know why it was going so damn slow. Unless it's a Pokemon I don't have yet, I'm not gonna bother with trying to catch it. Espeon and all that. So I would never bother trying to get them damn stones, bro, to knowing they had the forms already available. I guess it's better because I can just evolve it as necessary. Maybe a special attack which should reduce it. Okay. It is kind of hard to see the greens. Wouldn't it be funny if like a Kabutops was there on the ground there or something? Like a Butops was down there. Soundtrack, the soundtrack is actually good. Let's turn this up a little bit. Laboratories. But that's what we're looking for. It must be one of the buildings the professor was talking about. Yeah, they call that the radish rations. Research stations. Well, that was close. That was such great mirror. Dude. All this, like, can we just go into the damn building? Do we have to have a conversation prior to this shit? That's a Pokemon La Primera uses. I didn't know the species could be found in the Great Crater. Come on, let's take it on together. I'm gonna just catch this damn thing. No, let's take it on together. No, I'm gonna take it on by my damn self. This is not a team effort here. Like, I wanna catch this thing. Oh, we can't catch it. Oh, fuck that. Pokemon down here, don't you think? Patronizing much? But do they have to? Thank you. Dusk Stone. Oh, I found another Pokeball. Another item. What is that? Is that that? Oh no, I got one of them. I'm gonna see something gleam over here. Ah, it did, okay. So all these things be catching my eye. Like, that's the issue with being hurry back to the other so you don't get separated. No, fuck, I'm just trying to get the damn item. It was an item by that damn tree. Ancient ruins. Far too recent for that appears to be the first research station without incident. Facility was constructed 87 years ago. La la la. Where's their bed? Looks like some we can use this place to rest up. If we'd be so kind to disable the first lock on it. This dude over here is too emotional for me. It's Arvin. Trying to go nowhere yet. I just want to get that item before we leave. And now it's time for a backstory. Wait, what damn you see your daddy? You should know what he looked like. Can head to Area 3. I'm not finna venture too deep. Not right now. This is about ending the story. We did everything else. We beat the gym leaders. We beat the Titans. We beat the Team Star bosses. We beat the Elite Four. Oh no, what the hell? That's sending us back. I thought that was. No, we didn't want that. No. Gotta go lower like this. skittish boy. I'm a little insect. Insect Pokemon are fucking. They're gonna charge at you, man. Let's head in and take a breather. Look, is this really a necessary conversation, bro? Can we talk after we hit the switch? I was in the compliment, you know. Look, it's Delibird. Get to see some nice familiar Pokemon going here. Nope, that's Iron package or iron fluff or whatever the fuck. Battle time. I traded, so I don't give a fuck. I wonder if these final boss Pokemon. See, what was that? Darn thing scared me half to death. It was definitely kind of mechanical looking for a Delibird, wasn't it? No kidding. Come on, let's get inside already. One more jump scare like that and I'm done for. Seriously, what's with this place, that Pokemon? I've been wondering about that myself. I think maybe that Pokemon was one of these. Monsters of Area Zero. If we descend further into the Area Zero, we catch glimpses of mysterious Pokemon. Though we wonder if these compact, cruel beasts were indeed Pokemon at all, one of our teams suffered a brutal blow. Such a beast was mortally wounded, forcing us to retreat for a time. Members of the survey team captured this photograph by chance and noticed a passing resemblance of Pokemon at Donphan. Yet resemble their differences as such as its texture. The way it moves suggests it was biologically separate, to say nothing of its treads of iron. So they're like actually Pokemon? I don't really know. What do you think? Maybe definitely look different. I suppose the time has come for an explanation, Professor. Some of the life forms you see residing in within Area Zero are future Pokemon that lived in a distant day we have yet to see. Future Pokemon. Oh, come on, no way that's possible. The Zero Lab, which I am located, contains Time Machine. It summons the future Pokemon to this place. After my dad spent researching forever down here. Can I get it working? Indeed, though the cost was catastrophic. A time machine, you actually mean you can travel to and from the future? It is theoretically possible to travel to the future. However, for A being such as a human, it would not be possible to return to the present. That's horrifying. Why'd you call us to Eros? If possible, I'd like to speak about this face to face. Easy for you to understand once you see the situation yourself. All right. Please use the central panel here and disable another lock. You know the book you told me to bring? I think it's got something to do with this place. Or more like everything to do with this place, but I'm not the one he expects to fix whatever it is you are. I think you should be the one to carry it. Rest. Let's keep going down. Mona's parents don't even know about her. That looks like a shiny pony art. There we go, Lace. Of course, there's a damn gold duck down here. Oh, there's the other facility. It's number 3. There's a little gleam, wasn't actual. Seeing gleams, but they. Iron tread. See? Anyway, it's just like that Titan Pokemon we saw. Why is this? See, hell no. Thank you. it. Get it out the way. Victory is ours. Maybe the one we saw when we were researching out the Urban Mystica came from down here. Gonna meet one of these Pokemon before our creator get together? Jealous. So bring the rest of Toro over messes up. Come on. This is weird. I'm gonna have to do another restart. They made it to station number 3. How are we doing after all that walking and battling and whatnot, and when you're in rest? Feeling rough? No, it's not that. We've just been thinking since the professor mentioned that time machine. The Pokemon in Area Zero came to our time from a future, right? So what about Maridon? Isn't it pretty likely that the Pokemon is one of those future Pokemon? Wait, considering the way it looks, yeah. Like, you're onto something. It's kind of doing kind of future vibes. Dude, his name sounds futury. Wait a second, they totally forgot, Arvin. You had Maridon's ball, and you told us that his form, about his forms in the first place. You must know something, right? And you still remember that from way back? No wonder you're everybody's little star pupil. Guess I got no choice but to tell you what I know. The Pokemon Maridon, that is, I found it by my dad when he was working it on the time machine. It would be best for me to take over the explanations at this point. Right on, which I trust the formula, was the first Pokemon that was successfully retrieved from the future by the time machine. Through the analysis of its genetic makeup as well as its behavioral patterns, I came to realize that what I had discovered was in fact a futuristic form of Cyclizar, the Pokemon commonly written in this region. That makes sense. They do look alike. Many other Pokemon came to this place from across the boundaries of time, but I was never able to bring over more than 2 specimens of Maridon. And there's another one around here somewhere. With their family, the other one could still be somewhere in Area Zero waiting to finally be reunited. Oh, the faces are fixed. Okay, never mind. There they are. Thank you. Gray, I needed me one of these. Definitely gonna snatch one of these up. Poison rock. More petals are made from crystallized poison energy and recently become evident that these petals resemble terror jewels. Really? Well, I kind of wish they would give you like anyway. Look at all these huge, gorgeous crystals. They go all the way to the bottom. We're slipping, we can kiss our short lives goodbye. Good call, watch your step. So the professor was down here somewhere waiting for us. That's fine. Totally fine. Everything. Watch yourselves. Let's get to the bottom of this thing. Oh, God. This girl and her. Shut up. Let's just get to the bottom. It's just me and do Pokemon. It'll give it all the same glow as when Pokemon terrestrialize. There'll be some sort of connection. One way to find out. Come on, everybody. Let's keep moving. We gotta get all the way down. Just seeing things. Thought I seen something in the corner of my eye for a minute. So the Rhydon came through our age, through the time machine. Hello, children. Professor, you scared us. I'm sorry. Why is everything here all busted up? I'm sorry. Hello, children. This is sorry. Hello, children. What the heck? They're creeping us out. Initiating restart. Looks like we're having some kind of weird connection problems or something. It definitely was weird, at least almost like, I don't know. If he meant it as a joke, it wasn't funny. I got goosebumps. Well, can you hear me now? Please forgive me my previous transmission. There was seemed to be some signal interference. That's not what it was. That's not what that was. What do you mean? Locks have been disabled. Please make your way down to the Zero Lab, which lies to the Area Zero Bottom or whatever the hell. I don't know. Now, wouldn't it be something messed up if he ended up being like a robot or something? That'd be some shit. Terror shards are supposed to do. I got a lot of them. Oh, it's a baby form of that. Okay. I'll catch that for the Pokedex. A Glimmit. Didn't know this thing had a previous evolution form, but okay, we found out. Still not coming out the damn Pokeball, huh? minute ready to see those Legends of Treasure down here for real. Yeah, that's just fluff. They write it to fill the textbooks. What you doing? Wait a minute down here. The structure you see before you is Zero Lab. The crystals here in Area Zero possess a peculiar energy. The energy can alter the functions of living things and optimize the performance of machinery. It's the same energy that allows Pokemon to terrestrialize. So the entire building has been terrestrialized, is that what you're saying? Don't be silly, Arvin. The professor implied something important about Terra Orb just now. They're made from the crystals down here in this Area Zero. Though not many know it. Since you have disabled all four locks, the gate to the Zero Lab should open for you now. Once you open the gate, you'll be quickly when confronted with the dangerous Pokemon inside. They'll likely break for freedom. Before you working together, I doubt you should be able to best them. So we hit all the goddamn switches, and now we gotta hit another switch. Oh, damn it, bro. What the hell? Wow, we're finally on the cusp of getting into the lab. Look, we shoot a bunch of things. Shouldn't we also have Maridon help? Yeah, Maridon is like the first to saw it, Intel, Grotto, whatever the hell. I want to see a battle. Was it having, but it hasn't even let us run a ride ever since we came down to Area Zero. It can't enter battle in its battle form in the first place. It's really strong, I know it is. The 8-0's upper mystical we found when it really mattered, I'm pretty sure it'll fight. And Area Zero is where it used to live. If you bring it out and it was bald, maybe it'll be able to find its family too, right? Pretty sensible by your standards. Oh, God. We got Maridon ready. It's time to open that gate. Are you bummed that your heartwarming family reunion got cut off so quickly? I'm joking, right? There's nothing heartwarming about it. We're this close to getting caught up in a nasty brawl all week, for real? Look terrified, this other one is exactly its pal. But our Pokemon is giving off some really bad vibes. Nothing you should worry about anything like that. Once it gets you back to your battle form, I'm sure you're going toe-to-toe with that jerk. So I guess it doesn't really help. I think the other Maridon is one of the dangerous Pokemon Professor warned us about. Then the professor said the dangerous Pokemon would come from inside. I mean, from inside the gate. Surrounded. It's pretty obvious they're not here to roll out the friendly mat. There's no way we can handle this many. Don't tell me they're our future Pokemon. Got a little disaster on our hands. Look, even that fiddle's ringing the bell. This is my turn. I've been waiting. This is a worthwhile challenge. I'm glad you're on our side, but you're still really annoying when you say stuff. Very fucking annoying. You're running coming at me. Help me out here. So how come Arvin and the other two ain't teaming up? Pokemon go out, we're gonna have a gigantic mess in our hands. We'll have to go after them. Why me? Hold on a moment, why do I get the feeling that you're enjoying all this? The two of them can handle their part. At least the crowd's been thinned out now. I guess it's up to us to deal with what's left. Power friendship man was perfectly in sync with that Titan Hunter. Still scared, you worried you might have to face the other one of your kind? Well, let me take on some of the burden. The struggle should be nothing. Me and my back are both still gonna take it on. Me and your partner go take care of business. Make sure you got the same faith as the last. Both still can't wait to battle either. Right on. really ruined my whole childhood, you know? It's not like seeing you cowering and scared out of your mistakes but making you feel any better about it. Got amazing powers if you just use them. And you've got us, so don't even think about losing to that jerk. Brave, stand up and fight. Ugh.